Good morning, students. It's me, your Madhesh sir. Today I have come back again to explain you about the first lesson, the best advice I ever had. This lesson. If you see the title, the best advice. Who advised? I ever had. Who is I refers to? I refer to Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Understand, student? I refer to Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Then who advised her? He is only none other than our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhiji. He advised her. See, even in our actual life also, many advise us. Even we advise many, but few will take and few will not take. That is what we have to filter all the hearings, what all we get it from others. Then we will understand, then that only if you put up into practice, one fine day definitely we will be in the better way. See, a piece of advice which was given by Mahatma Gandhiji in this lesson has brought a revolutionary and changes and miracles in her life, she says. Who says? Vijayalakshmi Pandit. She says, she herself shared this story into a magazine. That is what she is going to explain in this lesson. Let us see what she is going to say, what all the incidents happened in her life, why did she meet Gandhiji, what did Gandhiji advise, where she was, what all the changes occurred in her life, everything let us see in this lesson. You see, students, you come to page number 1. Everybody, I hope you all are having textbooks. Also, you come to page number 1. You keep your pencils ready and I'll be telling off the words to underline and to write down the meanings. You must write down that. Then only you will understand the lesson very clear at all. Then, if you come to page number 1, you see, some of the famous women personalities are given in the paper 1, in the first, in the beginning only, that all the personalities you might have understood, who are they, also you know well. I hope if you don't know, please later on, there is a blanks to the down they have given. You try to find them and you write down their names over there. Then if you come down, there is a lesson. Now let's start a lesson. The lesson given below is an article written by Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit, one of the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's sisters. She wrote it for the Reader's Digest. It is called as magazine. Within the bracket is mentioned, you see, when she was the High Commissioner for India in the United Kingdom. See, students, this lesson, you mean this article in the sense here, article refers to the lesson which is given, which is written, which was said by whom? Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. This extract is being written by Vijayalakshmi Pandit to the magazine. Which magazine? Monthly magazine. Which is that monthly magazine? The Reader's Digest was the magazine which was very popular at that time. She had written this story to that magazine to reveal and to express the incident which had happened in her life, to give very good message to all of us and to learn and to follow the advices the people when elders give. See, actually this lesson moral, actually from the title itself we can understand, a piece of advice when Gandhiji has given me, which has brought revolutionary changes in me, then these all the changes occurred in my life, that all the changes are so and so, so and so, so and so, so and so. These advice many give in your life too. Why can't you follow the advisors if are good? Definitely elders will suggest only in a good way. You follow that so revolutionary changes will occur even in your life too. That is the only message she conveys through this our life story. Who is this Vijayalakshmi Pandit? In the sense, she is one of the our first prime minister's sisters. She is one of the sisters of our Jawaharlal Nehru. Now students, come to page number 2. Let's move on to the first point. These all the words are shared by Vijayalakshmi Pandit. So wherever I comes, that all refers to Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Now you see, the first I read complete point, then I explain point by point, you listen. The best advice, I keep your textbook ready, have a look on the points which I am reading. The best advice I ever had from one of the greatest souls the world has ever known, he is only none other than one and only Mahatma Gandhiji, on a sunny afternoon a decade ago. See, the best advice I ever had till now, I didn't get that much good advice from anyone else in my life. That I got it. I got that opportunity. That to who is that? He is a great soul. Who is that? He is only our father of our nation. Who? Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. When he gave 10 years before, a piece of advice which has been given by him has brought revolutionary changes in my life. Point number 2. Most people pass through a period of anguish when their belief in humanity is at low ebb. I was in such a period. My husband had recently died. My deep sorrow over his loss was followed by humiliating realization that he is in the eyes of Indian law, I had no individual existence. Along with other Indian women, I had participated for years with men in the national struggle for the freedom, working and suffering side by side with them until it had finally been achieved. But in law, we women were still recognized only through our relationship only to the man. How nice these words are said by this Vijayalakshmi Pandit. You see, students, most of the people pass through a period of anguish when their belief in humanity is at low ebb. You see, anguish means, already I have written here, physical or mentally pain. You mean somewhat sadness, that's all. So many people pass through that. You mean even we too will pass, you too will pass, everybody will pass. Where? Through this anguish. You mean obviously that sadness will be there. We cannot be 24/7 happy. Sometimes the situations or the circumstances may create any kind of scene, like happy or sorrow or whatever it may happen. That is what I'm telling you. Now, many people pass, all of us, not many, everyone passes through this anguish moments. Even I too faced, even I was in a such period, even I too was there once in such condition. My husband, what was that condition? That condition only, my husband had recently died. Whose husband? Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit, she is telling that my husband passed away. My deep sorrow over his loss was followed by humiliating realization that in the eyes of Indian law, I had no individual existence. See, I was in deep sorrow. I could not express, I could not realize actually what had happened to me after I have lost him. Not only that, I had also realized about the virginality and the fact of our Indian law. Or else I could have not known about our Indian law. Along with our Indian women, I had participated for years with men in the national struggle for freedom, and side by side with them until it had finally been achieved. But in the law, we all women were still recognized only through our relationship to the men. That is what the students. Now here you see what she is telling next. When such an incident had happened, when I was in completely agitation, you mean confusing mind, what to do, what to be done, what not to be done, what to do, what not to do, where shall I go? Because no one was there to worry about her. She was in deep sorrow and she was somewhere deep in completely sorrow, whereas there was no person to care her. Then finally she decided herself to come out from that, because she had children too. She has to sacrifice many things for her children, she decided. Then she got one and only the way. At the same time, the freedom struggle was going on in the nation. Many men, women together, they were participating to kick out the British from our nation. She too has grabbed that opportunity. Why can't I join them? I will also join. Then I too get some awareness about the society. Then I could do something. I can achieve something in my life. I can do a great for my children. I can get back my husband into my life. That is what none other than only me. She herself decided and she joined the freedom movement with men. But you all know that what all happened. Often lot of struggle, lot of circus, lot of reasons, many failures. Freedom is, freedom has come. You mean no, sorry. Freedom is taken. It is not given by British. We have taken it. We have kicked them. We have sent them out. Then we have taken. Even she too was there in such a scenario. Then that has brought some mentally relief in her. Then what happened? Third point, you see students. Now, as a widow without a son, I was not entitled to any share of my family property, nor were only my two daughters. I resented this gallant position. I was bitter towards those members of my family who supported this antiquated law. See, first point, third point, first line, entitled. Entitled. You underline right there, having right. Right, having right. Then, or again you see, as a widow, I could do nothing. What I could do? I could do only something for my children. I could go to the leaders to participate with them. Apart from that, I could do nothing. And also I could do everything. But only one thing I could not do. That is what I had no rights to get my property share from my family members, because the law says that, which law? Our Indian law says that you have no sons, only two daughters. So that his property, my house property, her husband's property only will not be given to you. That was encouraged by antiquated, you underline antiquated in a sense, followed, supported, who supported and followed? Even their family members. Their family members means, oh, her husband family members only followed that law. Anyhow, property is there. Anyhow, our India is law also like that. What that law says, we should not supposed to give the property the people who have no son. Anyhow, this law is in favor of us. So she was almost completely neglected by her husband family. Next. At this time, fourth point, at this time I went to pay my respect to Gandhiji and say goodbye before leaving for America to take part in a meeting. I mean, conference is given there. You underline, you write down there, conference means meeting. After lot of struggle, after many incidents, these are all secondary. Then finally, she had reached some benchmark and she had come to Gandhiji once to take the blessings from him, because she was elected by our Indian government as a delegate to the America to participate in the conference. So she went to Mahatma Gandhiji to take blessings from her, for him. Then after our talk, he asked, have you made your peace with your relatives? I was amazed that he would do take sides against me. I have not that quarrel with anyone else, I reply, but I refuse to have anything else to do with who have taken this adventure of an outworn law to create a difficult and humiliating situation for me. Then I went to Mahatma Gandhiji. He blessed me while talking about all this. Soon after completing all the discussion, he has asked me that, have you made peace with your relatives? I was amazed. You mean, I was shocked. How come Gandhiji knows my family story, that I have fought with them? Not fought. The quarrel or the misunderstandings between my husband, family and me. How come he knows? Though she says here, she replies here, whom? Mahatma Gandhiji, that no sir, I have not had quarrel with anyone. Then how come I can make peace with others? Then you see, he says, I know everything, but then finally she to accept it and she says, I don't want to make peace with the people who have used law, by using law who had made me to face these many difficulties in my life. I don't want to go back to them to make peace with them at any reason at all. This was strictly replied by expressing her sorrow to Mahatma Gandhiji. She said, come on to the fifth point. Gandhiji looked out of the window for a moment. Then he turned. Who turned? Gandhiji. To me, and smiled and said, you will go and say goodbye, because courtesy and destiny demand this. In India, we still attach importance to these many things. You mean, see students, you underline, see, Gandhiji looked out of the window for a moment. Gandhiji was peeping through window. So he was watching through window. He was seeing through window for a while. Soon after that, suddenly he smiled to her, whom? Vijayalakshmi Pandit. You know, Gandhiji smile. He will have smile always on his face. That is, he was popular with his smile always. That is what? He was very popular, and even he asked everyone not to quarrel, not to fight, not to create violence. He followed non-violence, non-violence, non-violence. Then you see, you will go and say goodbye, because courtesy and destiny, you underline there and you write there respect. See, what I tell you, you are going to America, right? You go over there, but before you go, however they may be, whether they may be good or bad or whatever, just you go there, you are not going to stay with them. Just you take their wishes from them, because for these in India, still we are having some importance for respect and courtesy will demand this. You mean these are having some values and ethics, still that attachments are there in India. Please you do that. Then, no, I declared, I means who? Vijayalakshmi Pandit. I declared means here you underline. Declared in the sense, she said, she told, announced, anything can be written. Then, not even to please you, will I go to those who wish to harm me? You mean, should I go there to take blessings from them, one who made me to face such type of difficulties in my life? I never go, sorry. I never go to please them at all in my life. These words were said by Vijayalakshmi Pandit to whom? Mahatma Gandhiji. Then, point number seven. No one can harm you except yourself. He said, he means he refers to whom? Mahatma Gandhiji. Then, still smiling. While smiling itself, he says, I see enough bitterness in your heart to cause you injury unless you check it. Okay, you underline the check it in a sense to keep something contained. You see what he says, no one can harm you, nobody is harming you, but one thing you keep it in mind, that you are going to be harmed only by yourselves, because already you are not at all happy, you are worrying about something which you missed. But whereas no happiness here and here, even if you go America also, you cannot be happy there. First you make peace with them, be happy. Happily you can go, you could achieve something, he says. That is what the message he has given her. Next you see students, I remained silent. Oh, Vijayalakshmi Pandit says, I was so silent, quiet. And he continued, you are going to a country, of course, which country? America. Because you are unhappy and want to escape from this. Can you escape from yourself? Will you find happiness outside? When there is a bitterness in your heart. Think it over. Be a little humble. You have a lost loved one. That is so sorrowful. You must inflict further injury on yourself because you lack courage to clean, means clean them. Clean your own heart. See students, eighth point I'm explaining. Again I'm repeating. I remained silent. I was very so silent. And he continued. Who? Gandhiji continued. What did he continue? He continued by explaining, by advising, how you are going to another country. You are unhappy and you wanted to escape from all these incidents, which all the misunderstandings, which all the sorrow, which all the difficulties you have here. Hope. Let it happen. Let it happen, everything good. Though, can you escape from yourself? Never. How come? Because that will be in your mind only always, wherever you may go. When you cannot have yourself, you cannot make others to be very happy. When you cannot control your mind, you cannot control anyone else. This was also said by, not Gandhiji, Vivekananda. A person, one who cannot control his mind, cannot control anything else in the world. That was popular saying which was said by Vivekananda. In the same way, he too says, whereas you have no happiness yourself, when you cannot be happy yourself, even wherever you may go, you cannot be happy, because happiness is not a thing to search. It has to be found within ourselves, what we have. That's all. Then, will you find happiness outside when you are not happy inside? No, never. There is a bitterness in your heart. Already, bitterness in the sense you write, already have written here. Unhappy. When you are unhappy here, how can you find out happiness outside? Definitely, it is highly difficult. Be a little humble. Try to come down. Try to come down in the sense, don't stick on to that. Don't be hesitate to go them and to make peace. Come out from that. Be liberal, be humble, be simple. Go there, make peace up with them. Be happy. Then you have lost a loved one. That is sorrow enough. We know, we can understand that how much difficulties you have faced, what are the situations and scenarios were being faced by you, because you have lost your loved one. We know that. Though this is needed for you to be happy there. You must inflict means cause. So it may cause again some other injuries when you don't make peace with them. I believe you think over it. What an advice he has given you, see here. I'm not asking you, I'm not demanding you, I'm not ordering you, go out and talk to them. It is left to you. But it may harm you personally. It may injure you. You keep it in mind. So that, please make peace with them. Point number 9. His words would not leave me. His words would not leave me. Then they gave me no peace. After some days of severe struggle with myself, I finally telephoned my brother-in-law, I would like to see you and your family, I said before leaving. Okay, soon after that incident, his words were completely in my mind. What a all that has brought great impact on me. Then while I was thinking so deeply about it, they gave me no peace. I was disturbed, confused, oppressed. Then after some days, I myself decided, after thinking a lot, I telephoned whom? My brother-in-law, one who was my husband's brother, and I have talked to him and I have spoken to him and I have told him that I'll be coming to meet you. I wanted to see you and your family. Point number 10. I had not been with them 5 minutes before. I sensed that my visit had brought a feeling of relief to everyone. I told them of my plans and I have asked for their good wishes before starting on this new stage of my life. This effect on me was miraculous. I felt as if a great burden had been lifted and I was free to be myself. So what actually I have decided, even to spend only little time with them, just to see and to have a look and to talk and to come back. But when I visited, that has brought a great relief in everyone's mind. They too were very happy for my surprise visit. Even I too was very happy, because after a long time I have met them. That is the only one thing which I had in my mind which had disturbing me a lot. Now I had actually come out from that. Now totally I am very free. Then I told them, what did I say? I have told all my plans, what all I had planned to go America, why I am going. Even I have also sought a blessing from them. Even they too were very happy by listening to that. Then that incident, I myself felt that as if I have been lifted by from a great burden. This small advice, a piece of advice, that incident had brought a great impact on me. Next, 11th point. This is a small gesture was the beginning of a significant change in me. A year and a half year, I was in New York as a leader of the Indian delegation to the Indian United Nations. Important to us was India's complaint regarding the treatment of people of India origin in South Africa. Harsh things were said by both sides. I resented the manners in which my opponents made personal attacks harmful to India's prestige and to mine. I struck back with the same sharp weapon. You see, 11th point, this small gesture in the sense, already I have written here. So action, actually it is action. Sorry, it is not written. Now you see. So gesture in the sense, action. That small work which I did has brought a great relief on me. Then it has also brought significant change in me. A year and a half, 1.5 year over, I was in New York. Then where I was? New York, as a leader of India has selected me as a delegation in the sense in favor of, behalf of India, she was elected as a delegate to United Nations to speak about our issues there. That is what delegation. Then important to us, very important issue there to discuss. What was the important issue to discuss over there in the debate? That is what? The complaint of our people from India that the South Africans were treating our Indians in a wrong way. They were ill-treated there. Based on that topic, she is going to discuss that the great complaint, what she had over there to complain them. Harsh things were said by both sides. You mean, I too have expressed through my point of view, even they too have expressed when this debate session was going on, where? In New York. I resented the manner in which my opponents made my personal attacks harmful to India's prestige and to mine. I myself had thought, and that situation made me to think what, that they are harming our India's prestige and they are also attacking me personally. That is what I got to know. Then I myself have decided to take very good sharp weapon against them. Then I to strike. Strike means you write down, strike them. I do strike by using same weapon against the opponents. 13th point. Before going to bed that night, I resolved that come what might, no word of mine would be lightly used in the UN. From then on, I lifted the debate back to the where it belonged, refusing to be relegated to the personal attacks or to the score achieved point. Our opponents met us on a new level, and from then we argued the case on its merit. Then that day night, what happened? Where? New York only. Still she is there only. In the same New York, that day night, she decided to think on the same debate she recalled once. So what all the polite and soft words I could have been used in the UN during that debate session? Did I use any wrong words? So why did I use such words? Then she took back the debate complete session. Why did this debate take place? What for this was a topic had been taken? Why did I use such a words? Instead of this, I could have used these words. in such a way, even that too, because you know, we all are human beings. After you know a certain mistake, we think, we realize if it is our wrong, though it is no wrong, sometimes we realize, not sometimes, every time, even whenever we make mistake, when we commit mistake, when you come out from that, we could have not done that, we feel, then suddenly we ask, we feel sorry for that. That is what she is also thinking. Then, before 14th point, page number 3. Before leaving the committee room on the last day, I went up and spoke to the leader of the opposition delegation. Opposition delegation in the sense, a person, one who was sent by another country, behalf of that country, to participate in this debate with the whom? Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. I have come to ask you, forgive me if I have hurt you by any word or action in this debate. Then what happened next after this, all the incidents? At last day, I went up and I have met whom? The opposite delegation, and I have asked him, if I would have hurt you, please, I am feeling sorry for that, she said. Then he shook. Shook is the past tense of shake. He shook my hand warmly and said, I have no complaint on you. You mean? He said that there is no wrong with that. Even I too have spoken, you have answered me, that's all. I never mind this. So he was very happy after my meeting. Then it was good to feel right with him, but even better to feel right with myself. Once more, Gandhiji's advice had saved me from myself. See what she says in this again. Why did, maybe he might have not yet felt that I have not yet harmed, I have not yet hurt him, but it will be in my mind, right, that I had hurt him. So that I wanted to get relief from that. So I remembered Gandhiji's advice again. So there is no wrong in going to the people again to ask sorry for the mistake which was done. So now again his advice helped me a lot. In these two incidents made peace with relatives and also here with the opposite delegation. You mean mentally relief she got from this piece of advice. Please you imagine what all the advices we people give you in the school, even parents give, even elders give, that all many countless, priceless, you mean, you know, we give many worthy advices we give. At least a simple piece of advice which Gandhiji gave brought revolutionary changes in our life. If you follow at least one or two advices which will be given by the teachers and also your parents, where you will be, just imagine. Then where we are, point number 17. Am I right? Yes. His words have helped me retain perspective even in small matters. Many women, I imagine, share with me a recurring nightmare. Someone important to you is coming to dine. The guests have arrived. It's a time to eat, but there is no dinner. You wake, perspiring, relieved to find it's only a dream. You see what will happen. Again, the same advice which had helped me even in another incident. Not only these three incidents, but totally that great advice of Mahatma Gandhiji has brought many changes in my life in each and every time I think that if Gandhiji stays in this situation, what is the advice he used to give, what he might have given me the advice, I think then I follow, so that I am totally free in my life, though let any issues easily we can tackle and come out from the problem. That is what her message through this lesson. Then she says, one day what happened, these words helped me. Retain means maintain. Maintain even in the small matters also. What is that small matter, student? See here. Come to page number 4, point number 18. But recently, it really happened to me. What had happened? See, many women used to share many experiences, what are the difficulties which they faced. But same scenario, same situation had come to even me. That is what my guests of honor, the Prime Minister of Great Britain and Lady Eden, could hardly have been more important to me, High Commissioner for India in the United Kingdom. You mean these two persons, who are the two persons? Great Prime Minister of Britain, you mean Lady Eden, they both are coming. The Prime Minister of Great Britain and Lady Eden, they both are coming because they are very important to me, because I am the Commissioner of India, High Commissioner of India in the UN or UK. So that they are very important to me. Once what happened, I had planned everything meticulously, from the menu to the color scheme of flowers and the candles. You mean once she invited them for dinner by arranging in a colorful way, by using flowers, candles, everything. Then what had happened, you see, when the guests had arrived and the drinks had been passed twice, I singled, in a sense, I called the butler to announce dinner. Then, but still we waited. When for the third time drinks came round, I excused myself and ran downstairs to the kitchen. You mean already they have come, they are sitting for dinner, but a person, one who cooks, serves, chef or cook, he is not at all there. 2-3 times I have given call, there was no response. Here the dignitaries are there. Then third time I did not think about anyone. I myself ran towards the kitchen. It presented me a shocking sight. You mean sight in a sense, a scene. You write there. Then in one corner stood a pretend little kitchen maid, maid in a sense, servant. Frightened in a sense, scared, panic. In another, the housekeeper. At the table sat my cook, waving a ladle and singing, beating time with his foot. His eyes were glazed and he was far away in some other sphere. The table was littered with pieces of chicken. See how the thing was. When she went there, she noticed the servant, one who had drunken. You mean one who had drunk, she noticed. Then what had happened, one was there, then the cook was waving and the ladle, and one was singing, one was sitting on the table. This all the scene she has seen. Then she thought the scene is out of view maybe, so now what to do, something has to be done. What did she do? You see, now my knees felt too weak to support me, but I have asked as a normal, in a voice, and I could do command, why is it not the dinner ready? I could have commanded on them, though the situation was not like that. So in a polite way, I have asked them because there also I have followed Gandhiji's advice. But it is ready, madam. My cook chanted, already everybody sit down, sit down. They are telling that it got ready. Then it was furious. It was on the tip of my tongue to say, get out, you are dismissed. When I thought of a counsel, counsel means you underline, you write there, guidelines or advice. Advice that had calmed me so many times. If I lost control, I would only hurt myself. See what she gets though. She was in such a aggressive scenario. What she is saying here, I was supposed to say, it has come to the tip of my tongue to tell them to get lost from my house. But that situation makes me to hurt only myself. So I could do something, that's all. So there will be an other alternative for this, but always it is not done right. Exceptionally, by unexpectedly it was done. So I should go in a polite way. If not, I will be hurt myself. I pulled myself together. You mean I have controlled myself? Let's get something on the table, I said. Then I have asked them, come, let's take this to the table, because already they are sitting there. Everyone pitched in, you mean helped. Everyone cooperated. They have cooperated me. The food served was not quite what the menu described, but when I have told my guest what had happened, there was a chorus of surprise. If this is what your cook gives you when he is drunk, someone exclaimed, what must he provide sober? Sober means drunk. See, everyone pitched in, you mean the people who all over there, they had helped her then. But the food served to whom? The guests was not the same what actually we have planned. Little different was there. Somehow we have managed the day. Then I have explained the things which had happened to them. Then they have surprised and they said that if he troubles, if this is what your cook gives you when he is drunk, someone exclaimed, what must he provide sober? See, so this is the cook, actually how he behaves. Though besides being a owner of this house, not only owner, the High Commissioner of India, couldn't you shout on them? Then the relief in my laughter must have sounded a little hysterical, you mean crazy. Hysterical, my perspective restored. I realized that a dinner party, however important, it is not the pivot in the sense center of existence. I have thought that dinner is very important. You are called for that. It is done. Then why I don't want to make this as a center of problems? So let it be. So this may not happen again. We have to take care so that we can advise them. They'll be all right. To retain a scene of proportion is as important as being able to keep one's heart free from heart attack. For all of us, no matter what the work we do, the advice of Gandhiji gave me is so great, meaningful. No one can harm you but only yourself. See students, what this she says in the last para, that what is actually important to us in the sense, so being important and being able to keep someone's heart to be happy by making peace with them, whatever, though we are hurted, whatever the work we do, it is not a thing what we do, but the Gandhiji advice made me to bring a revolutionary changes in every incident of my life. But not only me, you also follow this, she is telling over here, we too must, because she was not only the follower of Gandhiji. She was not only Jayalakshmi, but even Mahatma Gandhiji influenced, motivated, inspired complete world, not a nation. So there is no wrong if we follow his advice, so that no one can harm you except yourself. You are the only one who are going to harm yourself. There is a great message in this. If by keeping something in his mind, by worrying always about others, by thinking always about others, by speaking about always others, by saying about always others, instead of wasting time and thinking other, that, this, so on, so on, so on, so on, so, you will be hurting yourself. Give it up. Think over it. Do something. Then great miracles are going to happen. This is the message actually she gives throughout the lesson. So a piece of Gandhiji's advice had helped, especially in the three main incidents. Though she could get into trouble, but she did not get into trouble. She had overwhelmed, has come out from the problem in a very polite, normal way, in a soft way. That is what she has learned from Gandhiji. That is what, not only that, he Gandhiji says that when a proper time to be silent, when you speak, you will be in the trouble. This is also a popular saying which was said by Mahatma Gandhiji students. Okay, I hope you have understood the complete story of this, the best advice I ever had. Gandhiji advised Vijayalakshmi Pandit when she was in trouble, when she did not meet her relatives, when she had lot of misunderstanding in the family, when she decided to go America. Okay, then at that time, number one. Number two, when she was in New York while discussing in the debate against opponent delegation regarding a topic, whereas our Indians were being ill-treated by the South Africa people. Number two. Number three, the same incident when happened in her home, when a cook had drunk and when that nothing was prepared as per the menu which was given by her, where at home, though the Prime Minister and one more dignitary has been arrived to her home, she had handled that situation in a very soft and in a very polite way to come out from that without harming herself. That is what, don't hurt yourself. No one can hurt you except yourself. By saying this, I conclude, I complete this chapter. See you next class. Thank you.